Weeks. Canal Grande up then first. Bouncy, how do you feel about this, Woody? What kind of comps do you think we'll see for Canal?
I'm really excited to see this final match. We've got Code Magic Black cemented in third place, but it's up to this match to determine who will walk away with first place in the European region.
Yeah, all to play for now. Both these teams are very well warmed up and playing at a very, very high level today. We've seen some fantastic snipes from Twisty, and straight off the bat, one hits some Bentley, pushing Code Magic Purple very much into the back of their spawn, and SK Gaming off to a very aggressive start here.
Yeah, this is a brilliant beginning for SK Gaming. They haven't gotten any kills yet, but they did get that center star and are just pushing Code Magic Purple farther and farther back, even all the way into their spawn. Not able to knock down any of those bushes or obstacles yet, but Twisty Twick is doing his best. He gets his first kill, and that's going to be a charged up super for him. Expect to see this snowball start rolling down the hill. SK Gaming actually on their heels now. Twisty Twick finished off by Sun Bentley's beautiful sniper shot.
Yeah, great returning snipe there from Sun Bentley. Great positioning as well, pushing back on the middle part of that map, breaking that wall just to open things up for him to place some shots towards Whitey and Twisty there. Curse popping the tick head super down for some pressure, but shut down quickly there by Twisty in the mid. But overall, a great position, but Jaden goes down on that side, taking it to 3 stars now to 7.
Yeah, I saw some really fancy play from Jetten there, doing his best to kind of hop over some of those obstacles and get some sneaky shots off, but it didn't look like it paid off for him. Brilliant defense up there by Twick for the SK Gaming team, able to grab that kill and keep their heads on straight, except when he throws it off for his super.
Yeah, I mean, now with 20 seconds left, it can still be turned back around here. If Code Magic can just get a couple of shots, which one does land on Whitey. If Jetten can get into a position to really be able to clear up these shots, they could tie it on this right-hand side there. If this pinch continues here, Whitey's now almost down. Is he going to get the shot? Jetten just... Yeah. Oh my goodness me!
Gaming caught up in the crossfire there. Twisty Twick making a little bit too aggressive of a stab in there and throwing away the lead push far into the late stage of this tournament that has kept them ahead. That's what they said time and again about their strategies for the qualifier. It's staying focused and keeping your composure, even in the face of one of the best teams in the world. The CMP team mentioned multiple times that the other EU squads, and specifically SK Gaming, were their key fears for this tournament, and they're now going to have to face their greatest fear.
Very, very quick early exchanges there. Sun Bentley getting some good connecting snipes as well. Twisty very low on that right-hand side. Does need to retreat back here without giving away any of those stars that he's holding here. It is SK Gaming currently in the lead, but I don't think it's going to stay that way for long. I think there's going to be a lot of back and forth. And there, down goes Sun Bentley with a cracking snipe from Twisty Twick.
You know, I really thought that CMP had the advantage there. They were able to get a better spread for their brawlers and were starting to push SK Gaming back kind of into a corner, but when you push them back into a corner, they come back swinging even harder, it seems. SK Gaming grabbing that kill and leading now this series, or this game rather, 6-2. Can they hold on to this lead, though, and not give it up like they did last game?
Sun Bentley is honestly hitting so many of these shots. Got a nice takedown on a shill on that right-hand side. They're closing the gap. Whitey Super doesn't quite connect, and I feel Jetten's in a great spot here if he can get some connecting shots to get some pressure. But no, not if Twisty's got anything to say about it.
Rocket fire from this, blue Brock on the bottom side, firing away and providing that little bit of zone denial that SK Gaming wanted to kind of keep their momentum and mobility up. Wow, SK Gaming, though, able to get the drawback on. It's 11 all, and Tick's not looking too good, hiding in the corner over there.
Wow, the amount of plays that we just saw in the seconds there have brought it so much closer to give up. I think SK Gaming just managed to survive what was a really difficult position spot for them. Jetten going in here. Can he get anything done on this left-hand side? Tick head going in. Wow! Oh! No!
14 stars for SK Gaming. Jetten on fire on the left side there, taking another few pop shots, but not able to
side. But the pinch just wasn't enough. The gadgets were going off with the rocket lasers, jumps, and Piper Supers and all.
Once again, SK Gaming grabbing control of the center in this third game now. Twisty Chick earns that center star and a kill as well. Cursed found out of position, and Jetten now charging forward, looking for an easy kill, but not gonna find it. SK Gaming on a 7-0 lead in just the first minute.
What a dominating performance in those opening 30 seconds. And now 9 stars on the cards. SK Gaming clearly getting into a nice flow here. And Code Magic could have to do a lot here to catch up now, as it's now 11-0.
A game of chicken as both ticks out on the left side start squawking at each other, but it's gonna be SK Gaming once again pulling off the lead. Great shot there from Sun Bentley, able to get some stars, and once again from Curse now, pulling back a little bit closer. 2 deaths from SK Gaming are gonna put the damper on their excitement, but still with a 16-8 star lead, even though they're pushed back into their spawn, they have got a dominant lead in this game.
Yeah, it's one of those things, isn't it, where you've got that early start, the bounties increase, and it doesn't take much to close the gap now, as we've seen for Code Magic, but it is going to be an upward struggle here. Twisty with a great little jump there out of harm's way. Is Shill looking very low here? Does survive on 144 HP, but 6 stars now only in it, and 30 seconds left. It could all happen and turn around here for Code Magic.
Code Magic Purple needs a team wipe just to tie things up, and it looks like that's not happening anytime soon. Tick retreating back just far enough to stay safe. A few more pop shots here are going to push the Code Magic team back, but here we go with the final salvo. 10 seconds left, and it's all up to Code Magic Purple to get those final shots in.
It could all happen here in the next 5 seconds. If Whitey goes down and also the tick, it could change, but no! SK Gaming survive and hang on. But these games are so close, Woody. Yep, going straight in again. These games being very quick, not really any brawler changes. Both teams obviously very comfortable with this current lineup. And, you know, although it's not quite been going Code Magic's way, they definitely still feel like this comp is going to earn them a victory if they can just kind of collect themselves and gain back some of that control there.
YDE really hoping that he can pick up the win here and spread his fame. He's a creator in the Brawl Stars universe and says that the first thing he'd do with his prize money would be to buy 500,000 gems with creator code YDE. So if you're interested in stocking up, make sure to keep that in mind and support your Brawl Stars creators in this third chance for victory here. SK Gaming are behind for the first time, though, Ark.
Yeah, very different start here for Code Magic now with a pretty decent lead. Jetton's going to have to be a little bit cautious now. He has only a 4-star bounty. But with that Rocket Laces gadget, able to jump away from all of those shots that are bombarding down there upon him from a shill. So I quite like his odds now. And look how far back SK Gaming are pushing. Why he goes down the right-hand side.
Wow, it looks like somewhat desperate plays here from SK Gaming to try to get a kill. Code Magic Purple finally able to catch their stride and are holding on to that lead with a pretty dominant setup here. YDE sending out the Rocket Rain to try to knock down those obstacles, but not finding a kill anywhere. It's retreat for Code Magic Purple as they move back toward their spawn, but once again, even a team wipe would not be enough for SK Gaming to get a dominant lead here. They're charging in hard and fast, but can they get a hit?
Yeah, it's dangerous positioning here now for Code Magic, and they're going to be very wary of this. The pinch coming in from SK Gaming could turn things around very quickly. If Jetson goes down here, it could be a good start.
He does
go down. 10 seconds,
another
goes down. And look at this!
Protect the tick! Code Magic's curse is doing his best to stay alive, but with a great kill from the left side, Sun Bentley is the hero of Code Magic. The victory for the blue team. Set number one, Art.
Great performance there from Code Magic, turning things around. Can they now get the sweep, or can SK Gaming just get this one last round in, secure this? Let's see what happens here. Bit of a slow start, teams getting their supers. It seems like Code Magic get an early lead, though, however.
Denton jumps out of jeopardy there, able to keep his cool and gets another few shots off there, not able to grab the kill, but he's right on top of Akile now. Akile does his best to dash out and will find safe harbor on the backside. Advantage now for SK Gaming as they've once again grabbed an early lead in this fifth game.
Yeah, that gadget there. Oh, that takedown there from Twisty is very good as well. It's just so great to see these gadgets being used in to full effect here. Those dashes that we're seeing from Tick there, and those rock jumps are honestly making such a big difference in saving these stars and not incurring those deaths here. But now the positioning here of Code Magic is still back, pushed so far back into the spawn. They're struggling this time round, Woody.
Yeah, and a great spot for SK Gaming to be in with so much bush coverage right there in the center of the map and CM pushed back to their spawn. It seems like they're having a lot of difficulty finding a good angle to fire away at. Even if SK Gaming takes a hit, they can safely retreat back into the bushes, hide behind those obstacles, and then only pop back out when they find the opportune moment. It's really heart-wrenching to see Code Magic Purple doing so well in that fourth game, but then in game number five, now just falling apart. They really seem to have a pretty strong edge, but with these bushes set up, SK Gaming are not giving them even an inch to make it back in.
Yeah, Canal Grande is very much like that, and SK Gaming showing how it's done here. If you give up that mid control, it can be devastating. And look at here, Twisty Twix on 7 stars, a Shill on 6, a pretty open and shut case as far as bounty goes for SK Gaming.
A despondent Code Magic team sitting back as they recognize